Yeah, good afternoon, YouTube. Had the trucking company drop this crate off this afternoon. So we've been waiting for this stuff for many, many months. This is all from our machine shop supplier, and we've got a bunch of new parts here. Yeah, so these are the 1-inch rack and pinion steering extensions that we have. So they go on to, it's called the rubber rag joint. This would be your steering shaft. And the way these work is they fit over these two studs that stick out here. And then there would be the other half of the steering shaft bolts on here. And then these bolts drop through there and you bolt this spacer in. And like I say, you bolt the other half of the steering shaft up here. And you've extended the shaft roughly 1 inch. So yeah, we've got a bunch of those. So these are 1 inch, 1 inch, 1 inch. We've got the 1.5 inch. These are the 3-inch, 2-inch over there. So these are all our steering spacers. Okay, and these are our new Toyota driveshaft spacers. So these are supposed to have 5 different bolt patterns on them. So in the past, we had this spacer that had 3 bolt patterns. So there's a total of 12 holes there. And then we had these spacers that essentially have 3 bolt patterns. They've got 2 bolt patterns here, 60 and 65 millimeters. And then they had an alternate bolt pattern over there. So this new spacer, we did variable size holes. So there's one bolt pattern. And then if we go over here to the next one, let's see if those drop in. There's 2 patterns. There's the third pattern. We've got the 65 millimeter spacing. This is common on the third generation 4Runners and Tacomas. And then inside is the 60 millimeter spacing, which is common on the first generation 4Runners and pickups. And then this bolt pattern here is for the Land Cruisers, have this one. There you go, one spacer fits all the known bolt patterns on the Toyota drive shafts. We get a lot of problems with customers. They'll order one spacer and then find out they either measured wrong or they can't put it on the same flange. One problem you run into is it's not uncommon to have 2 or 3 different bolt pattern flanges on a same vehicle. So you might have this 60 by 60 millimeter pattern on your differential flange. You might have a different larger bolt pattern if you have a CV shaft on your transfer case. And then if you have a V6 transfer case, you'll have yet a different flange. You can have 2 or 3 different bolt patterns on the same vehicle. So here we can handle 5 different bolt patterns with one spacer. So yeah, one of the things we've been really waiting for is we've got a new shipment of our Ford 8.8 or Ford 9-inch driveshaft spacers. We used to only go up to 1.5 inches here, 38 millimeters. So we now offer a 1¾-inch as well as a 2-inch spacer. And these fit the Ford 8.8 or 9-inch drive shaft flange, and then it's got what's called a 2-inch pilot hole here. So these spacers go on to the flange. This would be the flange on your differential, and then you bolt the flange of your drive shaft, and then the spacers come with longer bolts that screw in there. So there's your new bolts. They're 12 point heads, metric bolts. These are high strength ARP bolts with the flange head just like the factory uses, and these are super strong bolts. We have them 1.5 inches, 1¾ inches, up to 2 inches, and then we have our other sizes 1¼ inches, 1 inch, 3/4 inch, and 1/2 inch. So we've tried to expand the range of sizes we have. And I've got to get 2 of these packed up because we've had a couple of customers that have ordered these and have been waiting for several weeks now. These are typically used on more like passenger cars will use the 2.5-inch bolt center. So sometimes they'll use that smaller one. Let us know if you need metric, which is M12 by 1.75, so it's a coarse thread, or if you have these holes here, which you can see are not metric. These are 7/16 inch fine thread. So sometimes these smaller bolt patterns are 7/16 of an inch, and the bigger bolt pattern is 12 millimeter. You need to check what's on your vehicle. So let us know which one you need, and we can get you the right bolts to go with these. So these are our larger pattern Toyota spacers. So these are used on some of the newer vehicles with the larger engines, like the Tundra and some of the newer Tacomas. So these have three different bolt patterns. The small one here is 66 by 66 millimeter and uses 11 millimeter bolts. And then the larger pattern here is 77 square. And then we've set these up so they also have 88 by 88 millimeters way out here on the side. So these holes right here get you the 88 millimeter. And then what we do for those spacers, just to finish them off, rather than supplying a too big spacer if you have the smaller bolt pattern, we supply this ring that goes on the outside here and just sort of finishes off outside. This one's a little bit tight. I may need to adjust the dimensions on the 3D printer for these. The new parts are slightly bigger. But anyway, the idea with this ring on here is you can put your bolt in there, and then the ring just sort of finishes off the outside so you don't see the gap there. The plastic ring isn't structural. The main body of the spacer, it provides your strength, and the bolt would go through, if this were the flange, it would go through there, clamp the two flanges together. But with these, we have one spacer that's got all three of the 11 millimeter bolt patterns, because that's the other thing we had trouble with the previous parts. We had two different spacers. We had this one, and then we had the two pattern, and people would order this one and then find out they needed this one, so they'd have to send this back, and then we'd modify it and send it back to them. So now we have one spacer that fits everybody, and then for the larger pattern you can add on the plastic trim ring, make it look a little better, and we have these in all the different lengths. And again, we have these 1/2 inch, 3/4 inch, 1 inch, 1 1/4, 1 1/2, 1 3/4, and 2 inch. So we've got all the spacers in all the different sizes now. With the Toyota spacers, these are the 10 millimeter bolts. We have all five common bolt patterns on one spacer. And then on the 11 millimeter bolt patterns, we've got all three bolt patterns on one spacer. So you just have to decide if you have a 10 or an 11 millimeter bolt. So anyway, I got to get the rest of these unloaded, get all these styrofoam packing peanuts put away, because we've got rain coming, so I need to get this all done before it gets soaked in water. So we've got both steering spacers as well as Toyota and Ford driveshaft spacers. This should get us back in stock. We've been out of stock on these parts for many months now, and we finally got a bunch in, so we should be able to fill orders. And that's the other thing I got to do, is I'll be updating the web page with all of these parts now that we have them in stock. I have to update the page to say we have them in stock, and then I've got to add all the ordering options for the new heights that we have, and then update all the photos with the new patterns and the new heights, so we can show you what all the heights look like. So yeah, if you have any questions about any of these, I'll be doing some follow-up videos on each of the different parts that we got in, and we'll cover those in detail in a separate video. We'll take another look at that. But if you just have any questions in general, post up in the comment section below. And I'll put the other videos over here on the left side. You can check that out. And as always, thanks for watching.